Today's the day that I unbox my Sony Xperia XZ3. As you know, my XZ2 Compact got repaired. That's fine, because a slow trickle charge won't damage your battery, whereas the quick charge tends to wear your battery out quicker. Although if you change your phone every few weeks, that's probably not a problem, is it? listen to music from my phone rather than like my computer or anything like that. So I will put that somewhere safe and probably never see it again, but that's how it goes, isn't it? Sorry to disappoint you all, but I bought the silver white, white silver, whatever you want to call it, basically because I did. What else can I say? Right, also, I'm going to put the SIM in before I power it up. You know, I'm going to assume, God, that's quite hefty. Actually, it's not as heavy as the XZ2. Seems quite a lot thinner as well, actually. Kind of like a Galaxy S8 or S9 build, you know, just a slight curve there. Now, yeah, in a change to my usual programming or usual methodology, I will keep this a bit safe. You never know what you might need to send it back to the factory. I'm going to put the SIM in. Sony, you don't actually need a SIM tool, you just need a bit of a thumbnail, fingernail, whatever. And here we have the SIM tray. Here's a SIM I prepared earlier. Goes in that way. Like that. Obviously, it's expandable with microSD as well, but it's 64. That's enough for me for the moment. Not going to be expanding that anytime soon. I've still got the hardware shutter button there. That's nice to see. If it was in focus, it would be nice to see, I'm sure. Power button, I guess that is in the volume rocker. Quite thin buttons, actually. Okay, let's see if it's shipped with any juice. Yes, it has. Okay. Safe, because you just never know. side-by-side comparison with the XZ2, if I can get it back from Joe. I'm not going to sign in, I just want to quickly go to the self-diagnostics just to make sure that basically that everything works on this phone. I'm going to skip that. Added them, I'm ready to go. So let's finish that. Optimize settings for your network operator will be installed and your device will restart. Okay, that's kind of irritating. Don't want that, that's all about. Oh, it's got this side touch thing, hasn't it? Yeah, which is meant to be kind of. It's a nice screen, it's an OLED screen, I believe, now on this XZ3. Here we go. Okay. App updates are ready, that's nice. Tests is what I want. And let's run all the tests. So, yes. So, I guess this is testing the camera. That appears to work. Can you see your picture? Yes, I can. Thank you. Oh my the camera button, do you get any feedback? I can even hear the feedback. So, yes, thank you. So, this is where, well, quite, this is like almost like a game. You have to, like, I guess it just detects the touch is working all over the screen. That's the added benefit of, basically it's a diagnostic test that lets you know your screen is working perfectly, and so far so good. The display turns black and white, look for different coloured pixels and tap the screen to continue. That looks pretty black to me. feel it. I can hear it. So, yeah, thank you. Starting Wi-Fi. Well, I know it's connected to Wi-Fi already. Test passed. Fails because it doesn't have a SIM in previous tests I've done, but I've got the SIM in. I'm hoping it will kind of work, although we are indoors, so it's probably not going to work. What I normally do to test GPS is when I am out and about, it's actually just make sure it can navigate me somewhere, because in the past I have had devices where, for whatever reason, location services just haven't worked. But I kind of think it's got stuck, like it always gets stuck. Okay. So we got as far as GPS, which always seems to fail. The charger, I don't have a plug or handy. I'll find out later if charging works or not, obviously. And my sensor cover the area above the display. Is the illustration fading? I think we can see that it is. Oh, it was. There you go, yep. So, yep, that's working. Thank you. Ear proximity. Side sense, no, please stop. So I have to start to stop it. Stop. Ugh. Side sense. Right, so yeah, that was working. Gyroscope. Well, gyroscope is the game. See, side sense is going to be really irritating, which is a shame because, you know, Sony are trying to add things like, you know, like that vibration noise thing, which is kind of useless as well, really, but at least they're trying, eh? Okay, done. That worked, thank you. So that's everything except the GPS and charger working. What I'm going to do now is, obviously I skipped everything, I'm going to just do a factory reset, and then when you're not watching I'll sign in and personalise it as my own device. So I don't like the fact you can't get the settings from just one swipe, you have to like do it again. It's kind of first world problem. So normally in the system, is it? Thing to want to do to reset your phone. Oh yeah, and look, it's updated to Android 9, so Android Pie. That's nice. So I want to go to reset, and I want to do a factory data reset, which just gets rid of everything. And let's reset the phone. Erase everything. Yes, everything. Doing a reset is taking the neighbors outside. 6 foot fall onto concrete. But hopefully, you know, at least lull me into a sense, a false sense of security. Sets your expectation of one thing, whatever. This camera can work. What I didn't check was how fast autofocus is, because on the XZ2 it's pretty slow. Friends of mine, possibly to be future enemies, who knows, as they become more successful than I am. But, yeah, we'll see. Until the next video.